played so many games this year over the years in places like this. They get tested every time they take the court. Good look for Fitz, but he missed it. Here's Ayayi knocking down the three.
See, what St. Mary's will look to do is they will look to attack. If they have an opportunity to get a layup, they're going to take it. If not, then they run their stuff.
Interesting matchup. Petrushev trying to guard Fitz on the perimeter, and he went right by him.
And not a matchup that they wanted to get, but because of the turnover, that's how they had a matchup.
Ayayi lobs it down low. Tilly with the touch. Defensive teams in the country. Gonzaga likes to play fast. They don't have to play fast, but they like to. Tilly with the foul checks out. Jordan Ford puts up his first shot of the night.
The size advantage that Gonzaga will have at all times, it's kind of like watching the Lakers versus the Rockets the other night. You know, size advantage versus small ball, and St. Mary's doesn't have a lot of size, and they've got to select mismatches at the offensive end to be successful.
That was Gonzaga's freshman, Drew Timmy. Jordan Ford off balance, scored anyway. St. Mary's regroups defensively. Neither team particularly deep. Corey Kispert having a heck of a year in and out. Timmy, offensive rebound, puts it back in. Rebound Gonzaga.
It's a high low.
Petrushev goes up and scores with a foul.
Now you can see it. And score and punish you inside.
Clock under 10. Jordan Ford with the runner. Good. Fitz posting up.
We have Woolridge on him. He should look to attack this immediately.
He does and scores.
For them to win a national championship. And then it's BYU and St. Mary's. Three out of the top four from the WCC.
Isn't that interesting? Timmy down low with a foul. Foul ball is at least fighting with him down there. Gets position and scores again. Yeah, I mean, well short. Gilder leads the way. Gilder over to Kispert for three. That one's good. Those are pretty good teams in this league. You get tested in the West Coast Conference, maybe in a different way than over the last several years. Killian Tilly, that quick release. The big man knocks down the three. Gilder came from behind and stole the ball away. Advon Gilder leaves it, and what a cut to the basket for Woolridge. Krebs looks a little out of sorts. Dukas throws it away. Three on two. This time it's Woolridge to Gilder.
But with Woolridge starting to communicate and hold guys accountable, I think that's the next level that you want to see.
Well, he found Killian Tilly. Wide open three. Gonzaga can't miss right now. Yeah, that mid-range two, that was a brick.
I call that a waffle.
Okay. Flip by Gilder goes in. I mean, St. Mary's is trying to find anybody down low who can guard some of these Gonzaga big men. Off the inbound play, Kispert throws it in.
Are you watching this?
This is as good as a team can play. Jock Perry's shooting a lot. He finally makes one.
Pull him out.
A missed shot. It had to happen at some point. Jordan Ford, meanwhile, blows right by the defense.
Stand though, why they're the most efficient team in the country.
Everybody's a threat. Inside, outside, Fitz over top, scores. And he'll get a touchdown low. Working his way closer. Spins back middle, took some contact and scores. And then the Hoosiers went out and did not play very well.
No.
Purdue beat him at Assembly Hall.
But an emotional scene. Pick and try to choose who you want to take out of the game. Inevitably, you're going to leave others open.
They play seven guys. That was a pretty good move from Logan Johnson. Petrushev, man. How do you shoot 75%? You get looks like that, and then you follow up your own misses and score just like that.
Well,
2 minutes of the half. Just a spectacular display of offensive firepower. Even Petrushev handling the ball and switch to the left hand for the finish.
And to close that gap and try to force him, and that's why you have so many weapons on the floor. You can't overhelp.
So many things have gone wrong for St. Mary's.
And allowing your opponent to shoot 75% for the half.
Woolridge goes to the bucket, hit the floor very hard. Mike for Gonzaga. Ford, meanwhile, had nowhere to go with the ball.
He's still shaking that left hand.
Yeah. Not great. Petrushev, score the basket plus a foul. Jock Perry makes his move and uses the glass to score. clock to six. Woolridge underneath the basket again, down to three, down to two. Gilder, nice shot fake, created the opening, and why not?
Very key.
You made the point, and I think it's worth revisiting. Killian Tilly with a runner, and that one goes down. So see this very often when it's two top rivals going head to head.
Well, the size differential is huge. And I mentioned it, like, St. Mary's has got to execute and play like they're the Houston Rockets against the Los Angeles Lakers. Nice job that time.
You know, a huge part of the mission for Gonzaga to close out this regular season. Tilly attacks and scores.
He's a spectacular player.
He really is. Jordan Ford, meanwhile, struggled in this game. Good bounce pass that time. Eventually a matchup like that in the Sweet 16. Kispert, the Elite Eight. Kispert to the free throw line, ducks in and scores.
How do you want it? Go ahead and have it. That's how I would describe the offense tonight for Gonzaga.
Ford backs up and shoots a three. Finally, St. Mary's has made one.
Gonzaga, and they're a level of efficiency at both ends of the floor tonight.
Well, St. Mary's finds an open shooter. Dukas knocks down the three. Woolridge down the lane, stopped, flipped it up, scored.
They all watch, everybody watches the NBA and thinks that they can do that. Well, those guys are mastered the fundamentals. Petrushev is not happy at all with that last possession.
Now Ford has the matchup against the big man. He used that extra little Euro step. Dukas tries to get by Tilly. There's Ford, runner, and uses a nice soft touch. A little better, they're still down 18.
Just feels like they're treading water.
Yeah. I mean, you got to get stops to make a run. They can't stop Gonzaga's offense. Bad pass. And Gilder saw that coming all the way. Gonzaga numbers over the top. Woolridge finishes.
Nice pass. Four assists now in the game for Gilder.
So you feel like St. Mary's getting back in it, playing a little better. Ford has it stolen away. It's a 23-point lead. Now it's a 25-point lead. Back. He'll shoot the three, way short. Wow, just not Jordan Ford's kind of game. He does scoop up the ball.
Plays St. Mary's close and wins, people criticize them. If they blow them out, like they are. Median, find me and give me suggestions, right? Dan Dickow decides to text me.
Yeah.
Say, get a haircut at my barbershop. There you go, Dan. There's your shout out.
We're looking for
their weapons and the skill set that you watch. And they play at a high level. They're used to playing in big games.
Tilly wants to dunk it. He will dunk it. Alex Dukas, runner. Good.
These guys, Harris has got to play faster. Okay, when you play small, and that's what he has to do this year, Randy Bennett. Well, you've got to play a little bit quicker. You got to. Not today.
Those teams and not this. You're right. Not around college hoops all day today. Petrushev right over the defense.
I think they will. You know, I think when you look at the season as a whole, 3-point percentage has dropped a little bit.
Gilder has been effective when he's been in the game tonight. Petrushev's going to try a three and hits it.
I definitely have him on the bench.
Kispert found his way into an open three. The big test for Gonzaga, and it did not prove to be. If the Zags play like this, it's going to be tough for anybody to beat.
Yeah. Churchill's. I've been to Churchill's. I have gone to Churchill's. I'm just kind of like, you know, I'm a comfy sweat guy. Now he's in the box score for points, by the way, too.
He's matched his fouls with his points. Sakharov.
I'm like a comfy sweats guy. I find something I like and I stick with it.
Yeah.
But you know what? I hear the cries of Spokane. I want to acknowledge them. And I'll try something else. And that does not, we're not changing our breakfast spot at all.
No, we're going back to Huckleberry's.
Yeah.
Sorry, folks. We're not branching out.
The breakfast burrito is too good.
Pretty good.
So you know it's also good? Yeah, Gonzaga.
Yeah.
What a night, what a performance. A 30-point win for the Zags on this floor, in this building.